to leave you better. I want my life to matter. I am afraid I have no purpose here. I watch the news on TV, abandon myself daily. I am afraid to let you see.
Tsitsipas, he wants to retire, but he wants to see the physio first. Stefanos Tsitsipas ne peut continuer le match.
We don't have to stay stuck in the
I've taken the very difficult decision to retire from the 2021 ATP World Tour Finals due to my elbow injury, which has been bothering me for a couple of weeks now. I'll be traveling today to see a specialist regarding my elbow. I'm heartbroken and I really hope I can get back to playing at 100% again.
You had your surgery at what, in the end of November? Here we are in the second week of January, and you've had what, 3.5 matches on the ATP Cup?
Correct. Yeah, my surgery happened right after Nitto Finals ended.
Yeah.
Your offseason was challenging. You had the elbow trouble. You probably didn't get as much training as you wanted. Have you surprised yourself with your level here in Australia this summer?
Well, I'm pretty sure my doctor is watching right now. He has been sending me texts after every single game. Frank, well, we both didn't expect for me to participate at the Australian Open. It was not part of our plan. He certainly told me, I don't see you playing in Australia, but I proved him wrong, but I
Netflix, why are you filming my neck? Netflix has been joining us for the 3 days here and filming lots of tennis and lots of funny moments behind the scenes. You know my humor, how it is. Like, I'm keeping them really entertained.
Well, I was the first person to know about that before any of you. I didn't have that privilege, so I had to really build my way up. I did have a few wildcards. I think first one was in Rotterdam with the help of my agent at the time. And I think also Richard Krajicek, which helped me a lot. He really wanted to help and gave me the opportunity to play in Rotterdam, where I played for the very first time.
Game seals it in style.
Do not forget the angel, see. You won't stop me. I never fight.
fabulous tennis. Turns defence into attack. It was all about the lob.
Honestly, I wasn't aiming for any titles or anything that week. I entirely just enjoyed every single moment with him, and regardless of whether we lose or win, it was all about having the best time I could out there. And we played some great rallies, had some amazing points with him, and that was already great on its own.
Given that there was so much uncertainty about how well you'd be able to play in Australia, given the surgery was so late, when you look back at the first Grand Slam of the year, did that go almost better than you could possibly have imagined it did?
I was not normal. Not normal at all. My doctor had planned for me to start playing first week of clay season, and I ended up playing not just the Australian Open, but the ATP Cup as well. And it threw him off. He didn't expect it. It was kind of a miracle in a way. And the fact that I was able to go deep in the Australian Open was the best thing that has happened in my career so far in regards of comeback after such a difficult injury, which I suffered with for many years on the tour. But for sure, I went through a lot of stress, a period where I didn't enjoy playing tennis anymore because the pain was so big and so intense that I wasn't able to enjoy the game that I loved the most. And I remember being at the NITO finals a few days before the surgery, and I was thinking of quitting. I didn't think back then that anyone would be able to help me heal and get back to where I wanted. So it was a very difficult moment that I had to go through, and I was in a very bad place.
After a season of night falls and pushbacks, after the heartache of wrong turns and sidetracks, just when they think they got you game, set, match, oh, 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 here comes a comeback. Just cause you lay low, got up slow, unsteady, don't mean you blacked out or bowed out, you're ready. Just when they think there's nothing left, running on empty, oh, 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 here comes a comeback.
To stay healthy and stay motivated, something that I struggled with last year because of my injury. I wasn't able to stay motivated because I didn't believe in myself because of my abilities. I wasn't able to be where I wanted to be, and my body was stopping me from going there. So it was very sad to feel helpless in a way. I felt weak, and I felt unable to
reach new heights.
I'm quite, very quiet, really quiet most of my time.
It feels great. I have great memories from here, and I can't wait to start again and show what I'm capable of on the clay.
Starting to find another level.
Oh, what a pickup this was, because that was an excellent drop shot. Tsitsipas there, balanced.
Well, Steph, first of all, I've got to say, it's the most extraordinary match of tennis I think I've ever seen. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Stefanos Tsitsipas.
Huge congratulations. It's a very elite club of people who've won back-to-back Monte Carlo Masters. Nadal, Borg, Muster, Nastase Ferreira. We can now add the name Tsitsipas. Tell us what that means.
Remarkable. For those that don't know, this is my first event I ever attended as a six-year-old child, kid. And not in a million years I would have thought that I would be in the position I am today. I've seen you for many years now. I don't know if we played juniors. I think we played juniors together.
In Bonfili.
I completely forgot.
Yeah, you beat me 6-1-6-0.
Really?
Is he number one right now?
I think quite possibly.
Hello everyone, thank you very much for your enormous support this week. Having fans back and experiencing Monte Carlo with such a vibe was truly unbelievable.